Hello and welcome to today's video where we'll solve a numerical in our stability subject, the topic of lifting of mass on board a vessel. You must know that there are some type of ships like bulk carriers, container vessels, etc., which carry cranes on board so that the loading or unloading of cargo can happen in a port where any such cargo handling facilities are not there. Even oil tankers have a small crane or other lifting arrangements near the midship for handling of various pipelines with regard to the bunkering or loading of unloading of oil into the ships. So there can be situations where you are operating a crane onboard a vessel, and that will definitely affect the stability of the vessel. So in this video, we will solve a numerical and try to understand the idea of how when a crane lifts a mass or releases a mass from a ship onboard a vessel, how that will affect the vessel's stability. So that we will come to know once we solve this problem. So allow me to discuss the question. It is said that 15 tons is lifted by a derrick, the head of which is 15 meter above the original position of the weight in a ship of 1250 tons displacement, whose kg value is going to be 3.10 meter. What will be the new kg when the weight has been lifted? First subdivision is to a distance of 2 meters, and second subdivision is to a height of 12 meters. So basically the question is, we have a lifting arrangement like a crane or a derrick, whatever you call it here. It is lifting a mass onboard a vessel, and we need to find out the new position of center of gravity, G1. So the distance mode, G1, that is what is asked. What is the new value of kg? That is what is asked in the question. And the first subdivision is, you are lifting the weight, the case A as given here in the question, you are lifting the mass from the original position to a height of 2 meters above. And in the second case, case B, we are lifting this weight from the original position where it was resting on the vessel to a height of 12 meters. So in both these situations, how will the value of kg change from this 3.10 meter, which is the initial kg of the vessel as given in the question? I hope you have understood the question with the help of this diagram. Well, let us try to solve the answer. Yes, here you can see I have just shown you a photograph of a vessel. You can see a crane on board, and it is doing this lifting operation. So this is one case scenario which we are trying to discuss in this question. So this is what we call a situation of suspended weight, and this is what we, the figure which we have constructed, which we understand from the data given in this question. So we have a vessel with some weight W at some position on the vessel, and we have a derrick which is lifting this weight initially in case A to 2 meters and then in case B to 12 meters above the initial position. We need to find out the new position of G1, the change in center of gravity, and the kg1 position. That is what we need to find out. Now we need to understand this fundamental thing. When the weight W is being lifted by the derrick, in effect it is as good as the weight is acting at this point A, where this lifting is happening, the fulcrum of this moment. So we can assume that this weight is acting at point A. Okay, so it is equal to shifting the weight from bottom to A. So we can also say that G1 will be parallel to WA. Okay, so you can see how why dangerous it is, why it is so dangerous to operate a crane onboard a vessel. You can see even if you are slightly lifting this weight here, in effect your weight is acting at this point. So this much will be the shift of the distance, and that will have a tremendous effect on your G. And if we know the basics in stability, we can understand that the moment G goes above M, your metacentric height GM has become negative and your vessel is in big danger. That is not something which we want, and for this reason, in each and every stage of this lifting operation, we want to ensure a positive GM so that we are always inside the safe zone. So we take this basic formula for shifting of center of gravity. G1 is small w into d by capital W, where small w is the weight being lifted, d is the distance moved, and capital W is the mass displacement of the vessel. So in case A, we can take distance d as the total height of the crane is given to be 15 meters. So 15 minus 2, 13 meters is the distance. So G1 will be 15 into 13 by 1250.156 meters. So this is G1. So this is definitely a rise in G because weight is being lifted. So your new kg will be 3.1 plus GG1. So the final answer in case A will be 3.32 meters. Similarly, in case B, I have lifted the weight to a height of 12 meters. So the distance moved will be from A to this point, that is 15 minus 12, 3 meters. Okay, so the GG1 will be 15 into 3 by 1250. You get 0.036 meters, and the new kg portion will be definitely the initial kg 3.1 plus 0.036, that is 3.136 meters. So this will be the value of GM, sorry, kg in case A and case B. So something very important you should understand from this question is, you know, when we are lifting this mass, suppose we are lifting this weight from this position to the top. So in this lifting process from the initial position to the final position, say here, so first you will reach case A, then you will reach case B. And you can see as we reach case A, your kg value is increasing, and as we reach case B, the kg values again, it is like this. This is how the center of gravity is changing in both these cases. I hope you have understood how this question is being solved, and I hope you are comfortable to now to solve these type of questions yourself. If you have any doubts, please do email me at pramod.imu@gmail.com. Thank you for listening.